Dead.
Okay, if you can imagine every prayer that has ever been prayed, every heartfelt desire, every desperation, every war, every crime, every bit of madness that we as humanity and brought to the table to God the sound of every heart crying out, every prayer that is being prayed right now, every prayer that will ever take place in the future. I can tell you this much, whenever I pray to God, this is what happens to me. This is called Karmic Prayer. Thank you.
Thank you. My freedom lies in the cursed of balls, but I don't surmise how I have it defined.
What is Karlovema?
Karlovema is an exploration of something that I call astrophysiotheology. Hey, can we get the gas light? We got to have this.
Everyone's
watching, man. This is where it's happening. Right here. Right where Bob Dylan gave hard rain to the world is where I am going to launch my ambition to create a new artistic culture and invite everyone on Tuesday nights here at the Gaslight. If you are a poet, a musician, an actor, a singer, a dancer, a philosopher, a deep thinker, a romantic, if you're a composer, a music arranger, if you're an astronomer, a physicist, a theologian, or if you just like good rock and roll, come here to the Gaslight every Tuesday night for Karlovema Nights, where we will explore astronomy, physics, and theology. That is astrophysiotheology.
We got her, we got her. Hi, Elizabeth.
Hello. That's the muse of
the muse.
Michael's artistic muse.
Yes. What is it like being Michael's muse? What is that? What is that pressure? Is a lot of pressure being a muse?
Yes.
Yeah?
But it comes naturally.
Okay. Well, that's good. You're doing a great job.
Thank you.
Oh, wait. Let's look at this baby. Tell me about this.
Well, wow. I'll tell you the truth, man.
Wow, that's... Wow, if that guitar could talk.
I was out on the street for about a year, and I was never homeless, but sometimes we can all fall into a trap that's difficult to get out of. And so, my muse, Elizabeth there, said, well, why don't you go out and play your guitar? You can make some money. And I went out there, not knowing how to play the guitar, and began stringing together different riffs, sort of musical poetry. And what came out of that was the rock opera that we're going to do here on July 9th of 2011. That's Saturday night. We want everyone to come out and bring your cameras and bring all your friends. Have a few drinks, have a good time, and explore Karlovema with us, music and art and poetry. And you can see this up close and personal. Everything seems to be wanting to move up, or is coming down from heaven.
Holy shit.
Thank you. This represents the multiverse, which I'll talk to you about in a minute. Many different universes that God has created. This represents the heavens right here. This is one of the characters in the opera, Sarah, the leading lady, actually. She's Ramavian's guardian angel and sings a song called Say What You Want, But Don't Say Goodbye. The name of the opera is Karlovema, an epic rock poem. One ambition, we've got to get this in because it's critically important for the entire world to get this message, which is coming to you right here.
I love fucking with your partner.
Live from New York City. Everyone, I'm concerned about the future of our world. I've written this book and this rock opera to raise awareness that unless we can come together as a singular global identity unto ourselves, a planetary race of human beings, we will not survive ourselves into what Michio Kaku, famous physicist, calls a type 1 civilization. Type 1 civilization is one that has harbored planetary resources and is no longer a threat unto itself.
Pardon, man. Is that a bar?
Yeah, go on in. Go on in.
I like your guitar.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
See, folks, this is a great place to be. Every Tuesday night to meet you. Type 2 civilizations have harbored the energy of a star. I believe this is something along the lines of 10 to the 26th power. If you're a mathematician, you will know the breadth of that. And lastly, type 3 civilizations are those intelligent civilizations in the universe that have harbored galactic power. That's something like 10 to the 36th power, I believe. Anyway, the point is, famed physicist Michio Kaku tells us that we're not even on the map. We're not a type 1 civilization. We may not make it unless we can come together. If you look here, you'll see the figure of Jesus Christ.
There he is.
And I wear this crucifix around my neck. The scope of what we want to embrace here comes from the idea, and in my mind, the actuality of universal Christ. Now, we want to take Karlovema, and karma in particular, in a new 21st century
astrophysiotheological term, a new definition, one that wipes away the notion of reincarnation or multiple lives, and instead offers karma as a present time experience. We examine the physical, the chemical, the spiritual, the emotional, and the psychological movements of all things that influence us and who we are right now.
Journey to the center of now. Journey to the center of now. Search and find and leave behind all that binds you in this world. Seal the deal with all that's real, no more alpha or omega in your karma. Beyond infinity, in sight of divinity, no more alpha or omega in your karma. Beyond infinity, in sight of divinity, journey to the center of now.
Alive in this very present moment, in terms of relationship to the one true God. This measurement is the true meaning of karma, and it is the means that we have to transport ourselves from the trouble that we find ourselves in today's world to possibly attaining that type 1 civilization that Michio Kaku teaches us about. The book came from modern pop culture from the 60s and the 70s on through until today. And for the opera, direct influences from William Shakespeare, ancient Greek tragedy, medieval drama, the story of Dr. Faust, either as written by Christopher Marlowe or translated by Goethe. So all of these different influences come together, and that's what makes up the libretto for the opera. So I've tried to round this out and make it a real classy effect. It's an epic poem set to music, psychedelic rock like you'll see in the videos that Tom and I are working on. Day and I, right here at 116 McDougal Street. Karlovema Nights at the Gaslight. You see that? That's no joke. That's the real deal, my friends. This guitar, that space. I'm suddenly reminded of Space Truck by Deep Purple. Pink Floyd, Sid Barrett, Iron Butterfly, Bob Dylan. This man, you hear him? He's playing again.
Hey.
You hear him? Yeah, you can't stop him. He's wonderful. He's going to be in our band called Karmic Apothecary.
Yeah.
But as far as general influence, that's what influenced the writing for Karlovema. But generally speaking, I love classic rock. Deep Purple, Stones, Beatles, yeah. Grateful Dead, right? Who are we forgetting? The Doors, Janis, Zeppelin, Jimmy Page, love Robert Plant.
Till dawn is the same. Spin me in my beacon.
And who am I speaking with?
Michael James Fry. It's a pleasure to be here and speak with you.
Michael James Fry?
Of New York City, yeah.
With an E on the end?
It's just F-R-Y.
You're kind of a neighborhood character.
Yeah.
With your trademark vest and hat and hair and beard. And we always wondered who you were. And then I introduced myself some time back. And you've started to tell me what it is you do.
Yeah, I'm in a line of work that's, to my understanding, new to the map of human knowledge. And by that, I mean the term astrophysiotheology. And through a study of what I call Karlovema, I want to formalize that as a focus in astronomy, physics, and theology. And in particular with theology, meaning a study in God or in what is divine. So my work is to link modern science with the Bible and see what comes a brewing from there.
The God who sends fire will be the true God.
Myself troubled with the notions of time, place, and meaning in particular. I haven't been a happy person in life, just generally speaking, and wanted to know why. I think we all want to know why. And with the frustration in Christian theology, I took loose study in Eastern thought and realized karma in a totally new way. That I believe could revolutionize how we view ourselves in this world. In astrophysiotheology, Karlovema means divine love and divine karma. Karma no longer in the guise of reincarnation or multiple lives, but instead through Karlovema is offered as a present time experience. It's a measurement between where our heart is and the holy heart of the one true God, you see.
The Lord!
It's all about right now. The physical, the chemical, the spiritual, the emotional, and the psychological makeup. All factors that key into right now. And strong karma is in close proximity to God. A weak karma lives in distance from God. This is my working theory. It's what my book is about.
Strengthening your karma?
Yeah, yeah. To the point of world peace through inner peace. And ultimately through universal Christ. I put Jesus Christ in the middle of this.
So you're a Christian, essentially?
Yeah, yeah. You could call me that, but I've been called everything. A monk, a prophet, a false prophet, an angel, a demon, a devil, a messenger, a blessing, and a curse. All of these things.
Seven. Sizzling. Singles. I'll play this hour that I picked up over the last week to play for you. The first is from The Suite. This is Man from Mecca. Dusty Show. More from Michael James Fry in just a moment.
Take a black man and think of what you had. Here's a wild cat. Take a white mouse hiding in a house. Here's a coward.
By the name of Rick Larson, L-A-R-S-O-N, and in his story, which is a true story, circumstances came about where he needed to research the Star of Bethlehem, and he did. He did it through an astronomical software called Starry Night, and essentially what it amounts to is you can pinpoint any place on the planet Earth and take a look at the nighttime sky. And the beauty of it is, with mathematics as we understand them to be now, algebra, calculus, everything that determines a trajectory or a curve, we can reverse the mathematics from any point on the earth and look at the sky. So he took an intense study in the book of Matthew, and there are 9 points that he details, points that were predicted hundreds of years before they happened, and actually materialized in the sky. He knows how it happened, and details it on his website, bethlehemstar.net, and in a DVD he has out. It's the most amazing thing I've ever come across, because in my mind, it verifies Christian theology as a mathematical fact. This figures into my book. I have 9 points in my own
book. What's your book now? Say it again.
On Karlovema and astrophysiotheology of the holy universal
matrix.
That's a big one.
Now, where can people get it?
Oh, it's not out yet. This is unpublished, and to promote that is the rock opera that goes with it. I know, it's a bizarre story, but I wrote a rock opera. It's an epic poem.
I've heard you play here on the stoop. This is an excerpt from Michael James Fry's Journey to the Center of Now.
Opera that was based upon the book, and the opera is intended to be a universal search for virtuous truth. And the beauty of it is our central figure is every man. You know who that is if I say every man?
Sure.
Right, okay. So we re-scrambled the letters, and his name is Ramavian. He is at the critical moment. He represents all of us. Our world today, are we going to annihilate ourselves or not? And ultimately, my concern in all of this comes from a thought that was handed to me by Michio Kaku. You know who that is? He's fascinating. In his book, Parallel Worlds, he details intelligent civilizations elsewhere in the universe, and he breaks them down to a Type 1, a Type 2, and a Type 3 civilization.
1.
Type 1s have harnessed planetary resources and are no longer a threat unto themselves.
2.
Type 2 have harnessed the power of a star.
3.
Type 3, the galaxy. And through something called Drake's equation, it's a mathematical problem in modern physics. It's quite well known in those
Drake's equation?
Yes, exactly. It poses certain questions in an intended order, and it begins with the number of stars in the galaxy, and of those stars, how many may have planets, and from what we know about chemistry in our universe, how many of those planets would support life, how many of those would support intelligent life, and how many of those would survive their own technology, you see. And this is where we're at.
What kind of grades did you get in high school?
D minus.
You did?
Actually, yeah. Yeah.
What was your best subject?
English, creative writing, yeah.
What do you think of a guy like L. Ron Hubbard?
I never read his science fiction, and as for Scientology, I doubt that intellect alone could explain the universe.
I think it's a privilege to call yourself a Scientologist, and it's something that you have to earn. And because a Scientologist does, he or she has the ability to create new and better reality.
in Act Two, there's a huge rock and roll ballet called Glimpsing the Event Horizon. It goes something like this.
Thank you. walking down the road all alone, feeling like there's nobody in any of the homes. A home is where you go to when you have no place to go to. The only place to go to is deep within your heart. Deep within your heart is your only home.
New music in my soul.
Thank you.
This song is called Ramblin' Prism Blues. It goes like this. Well, I woke up in the morning rambling my blues away. Yeah, I woke up in my morning rambling all through my way. Don't know about tomorrow. I need new walking shoes today. I went downstairs to the street corner, rambling in my turquoise sheen. Blue light special, mandatory scene. Wavy navy colors of confusion, welcome to the blue machine. Street fights are building up the walls, shambling destruction here. The firelights burn the city halls, shambling. That's called the Alice Cooper Complex. And what it's doing here now, I don't know.
This is where Bob Dylan.
His thing, right? It was called the Scrap RV.
Yes, and he stood right there by that CD. It's
where he did the car and did the whole thing for that CD. Anyway, the big why. The big why. Why write the book? Why write the opera? Why care in the first place? Because there, in modern physics, there's something known as Drake's equation. I'll be very quick about this, okay? It's an examination of whether or not we have other intelligent civilizations in our universe. And it's a structured set of questions that are put in an intended order, such as, what do we estimate the number of stars there are in the galaxy? Of those, how many are planets? Of those planets, how many can sustain intelligent life? Of those who can survive their own technology. This is where we're at. Are we going to be able to survive our own technology? Can we make it to what Michio Kaku teaches us is a type one civilization, to where we won't be a threat to ourselves? And so this is the big why, because I understand karma through this study of astrophysiotheology to be a present time experience. That reincarnation in the form of multiple lives is a myth, a rumor. That when we take into account the physical, the chemical, the spiritual, the emotional, and the psychological movements, everything that brings us into this present moment, as it pertains to personal relationship to the one true God, this is what karma is. This is what makes it a tangible, actual tool for spiritual healing. And this is how we can change the world for the better, literally by doing the smallest things for each other. I'm almost done. Get right back to the music. That small thing that you do each day for someone else, holding the door, picking up a package someone might have dropped, doing that extra little thing, could be the nicest thing that happens in someone else's day. And so I believe we can make this world a better place. Maybe, just maybe, get to that type one civilization. heavy singles, Dreams and Nightmares.
I'm gonna go get some more. I'm gonna go get some more. We'll be right back.